Good morning all, my name is Arjun. I shall be training you guys right now on simple basic accounting concepts. This is your first chapter of your CA foundation, also for your CS and also for somebody who's learning accounting for the first time. So I'm a chartered accountant. I've been training for last 7 years. I've been awarded the best tutor at CIMA for different occasions. So what we shall be doing today is we will run through the chapter of what is accounting, what are the different objectives of why we do accounting, what are the different kinds of accounting what we do, and also on the other side from the examination per se, we'll also try covering the important topics. This chapter should be covered in next 20 to 25 minutes. Hope you guys are going to be liking it, and if there's anything that you want me to improve, please do let us know in the comment section. Right, the first part is what is accounting. So before we go into accounting, what I'll do is I'll just run through a very small scenario which is going to make you understand few of the terminologies what we use, because it's going to help you guys in the further sessions when we talk about certain examples, you understand the terms what we use. So first thing what we'll be doing is understand how an idea gets converted into a business idea. Any idea to get converted into a business idea, we do something called as feasibility study. Under feasibility study, we shall be doing market, technical, financial, and legal. Now, what does this market feasibility do? Market feasibility clearly says, are there customers for my product? Technical says, do I have resources for my product? Financial, am I gonna get my money back and the return of the product? Legal, whether there are necessary approvals to start my idea. You cannot say I'm gonna start manufacturing bombs, and it might be that you might have customers from different parts of the world. You might have resources, you might also get the money, but the government of India clearly bans you from manufacturing. So once I have my idea ready, so what I shall be doing is I start raising money. There are two ways of raising money in the business. One, either I bring in my own money or I take others' money. The money what I bring in to the business, we call it as capital. Others' money, we call it as loan or debt. So the first thing is we understood two things. There are two ways you raise money. One is either your own source, which we call it as capital, or somebody else's source, which we call it as loan or debt. Now, next part is what are you going to do with the money? We shall invest the money so that I can start my production. So I shall invest in various equipments, land, building, computer, XYZ. Why am I investing in all of this? Is because these are the ones which are gonna facilitate my production. These are the ones which are gonna facilitate my production. The third part of it is once I have money, I've started everything kept for production, I shall purchase goods. Now, when I'm purchasing goods, either I pay cash or I buy it on credit. Then I employ resources to convert it into finished product. So when I have finished product, I try either selling it on cash, I sell it on cash, credit, or it remains unsold. Few terminologies which I want you guys to understand is when I purchase goods on credit, we call him as creditor. So the terminology, whenever we purchase goods on credit, we call them as creditor. Whenever I sell goods on credit, we call them as debtors. So we came into few terms. This investments what I've made to facilitate my production are known as my fixed assets or we call it as non-current asset, because they are the ones who are going to facilitate my production. So I assume that you are clear with it. We came across few terms, basically capital, which is my investment into the firm, loan, others' money, asset is something I own, liability is something I need to pay, fixed asset is my investment into assets which facilitate production, and last but not the least, creditor is the person whom I purchase goods on credit, and debtor is somebody whom I sell goods on credit. So just look into this terminology because it becomes very important for me when I go further to start using my topics. Done. With this, let's start. Where does accounting all begin? Accounting begins with identifying a transaction and an event, or an event. Accounting begins with what? Identification of a transaction or an event. So what's a transaction? We say transaction means a business, performance of an act, or an agreement. Whereas an event is a consequence of a transaction. To understand it bit better, now what does business mean? Business is purely for monetary purpose. Performance of an act or an agreement can be for monetary or non-monetary. Event is a consequence of a transaction. So I'll be giving an example with regards to accounting, keeping in mind a transaction and an event. Let's say X purchased goods from Y, 10,000. This is basically X has paid money to Y to purchase goods. This is a business, so it's definitely part of a transaction. So X purchased goods from Y, 10,000. X sold these goods to Z for 20,000. So X sold goods, then there is a component of business again. So definitely it's a transaction. Now see here, he purchased goods for 10, he sold for 20. Did he make a profit? Yes. How much? 10,000 rupees. He made a profit. This profit what he made is a consequence of two transactions. So the end result of two transactions was 10,000. This becomes a event, right? If you want more examples, pass, make sure that you comment below. We shall upload more examples on it. So the first example which I discussed right now is X purchased goods from Y, 10, sold to Z, 20. Because of this transaction, he made a profit of 10,000. This is an event. Now, let's come to what accounting is. Now, the definition of accounting says accounting is all about identifying transaction or an event. So what is accounting? Accounting is all about identifying a transaction or an event. Now I know what's a transaction as well as an event. This transaction or an event can only be of financial character. So I told you transaction can be both monetary and non-monetary. I shall be looking into transactions which are purely financial in nature. That means it has to be with regards to the money. Third one, it should be related to the enterprise whose accounting I shall be doing. So when I say accounting of Arjun, it should consist of all the transactions or of financial nature which are concerned with me. You cannot have a transaction of Rama, Lakshmana in mind. If I am dealing with Rama, yes. If Rama is dealing with Lakshmana, the answer is no. So it should be related to my enterprise. I'll give you another example. Just see this. Ram sold goods to S. S sold goods to L. So Ram sold goods worth 10K to S. S sold goods 10K to L. L paid money to S. Now see here, if R has paid money to L or L has paid money to R, I have no role in accounting. Whereas in this particular case, the money what L is paying to R is basically the money which belong to the S. It is related to me. That is related to S. Even this shall be recorded. So I told you we shall be recording transactions and events of financial character which are related to the business. Now, so let me just recap it. I said accounting is about identifying transaction or an event of financial nature related to an enterprise. Now comes three parts, which is basically recording, classifying, summarizing, and finally comes my analysis and interpretation. So accounting is basically recording, classifying, summarizing, analyzing, and interpretation of the results thereof. Now, what is recording? Whenever I find a transaction, I record it in a book, and this book is known as journal. Journal is the book where all the transactions are getting recorded. Classification, all transactions, let's say of similar nature, I try putting under one place, and this is going to be called as ledger. Summarization is done through a trial balance, which talks about the summary of all my ledger accounts. So all my ledger accounts summary is going to be done in a statement called trial balance. This trial balance will lead me to doing three things. First one is preparation of financial statements. Preparation of financial statement, which is basically your balance sheet, income statement, and cash flow statement. Now, when I say a balance sheet tells me on a particular day what is my asset and a liability. So again, I'm repeating, balance sheet tells me on a particular day what is my asset and what is my liability. Income statement says for a particular year what is my income less expense. So for a particular year, it tells me how much is my income as well as my expense. Cash flow statement talks about what is my inflow and outflow of cash. So if you look into it, I've summarized what is this analysis and interpretation. We'll come back a little later. Accounting is about identifying transactions of financial nature related to an enterprise, recording, classifying, summarizing, analyzing, and interpreting the results thereof. Recording is done through journal, classification is through ledger, summarization through trial balance, which leads to financial statements, which is basically my balance sheet, income statement, and cash flow statement. Right? What does analysis do? Analysis basically helps me to classify analysis. Helps me to club things under particular categories. So it helps me to classify what's a fixed asset, what's a current asset, what is an income, what's an expense. And interpretation is basically trying to find relationship between various items in the balance sheet and income statement. Now, if you guys want more details, notes about it, do comment. We shall be sharing the notes to you guys. Now, let's come to the next one. Why are we doing accounting? Now, before we look into the accounting part, let us just try seeing what are the things what I am doing. I said I'm doing recording. Then I prepare my trial balance. Trial balance, I make my income statement and my balance sheet. This recording, what I do, is my first objective of accounting. Accounting talks about systematic recording of transactions. Second, in an income statement, what are you trying to do? You are trying to ascertain the profit or loss. Third objective is balance sheet. In a balance sheet, what do you do is you are trying to know your financial position of a firm. So three objectives from the definition what we did earlier: recording, then balance sheet, that is to know the financial statement, and my income statement, which is going to talk about my profit or the loss. Then comes the last point. Why am I doing it? To make sure I provide info for decision makers. So I shall be providing my information to the various decision makers. Last one is to know the solvency position. So I shall be spending some time on what is the solvency position. Solvency position means to know whether my liabilities is more than assets or assets is more than liability. If assets is more than my liability, we say you have pretty much good money. Whereas if liabilities is more than asset, we say you are in a position of insolvency. So it becomes more important, because only if I know, have my balance sheet, I can make my asset liability position, which where I can know whether I'm solvent or not. So again, I'm recapping the five objectives. First one, systematic recording of transactions. Second one, ascertainment of results of the above transactions. Third one, to know the financial position. Fourth one, to provide information. Fifth one is to know the solvency position. Thank you guys. I shall be uploading the part 2 video tomorrow. If you have liked it, please do comment. Thank you so much.